डियर लर्नर्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम डॉक्टर अभिषेक घई, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट यूनिवर्सिटी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ होटल एंड टूरिज्म मैनेजमेंट, पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी, चंडीगढ़। आई वुड बी टेकिंग मॉड्यूल डेट इज़ बार ऑपरेशंस अंडर द पेपर फूड एंड बेवरेज सर्विस ऑपरेशंस एंड मैनेजमेंट। After completing this module, the students will be able to learn about the bar operations, various types of bar, parts of bar, know about the bar staffing, enhance the knowledge about the bar equipments as well. Firstly, I will discuss about bar operations. In the food and beverage operation, the alcoholic and non-alcoholic beverage plays the pivotal role. Alcoholic beverages demand, particularly wine, is changing and growing nowadays. To fulfill its demand, there are various types of bar in the market which sells alcoholic beverages to the public to consume on the premises. It means that bars are involved in the sale of alcoholic beverage. However, their main concern is to sell and consume the beverages on the premises. Now, I will explain about the different types of bar and beverage operation. There are different kinds of bar operated by the hotel or outside the hotel, which are termed as standalone bars. The classification of bar and beverage operation is not an easy task as other F&B outlets, because there can be so many blends of features. Some bars are attached with restaurants, some are associated with lobby, lounges, etc. So, a broad classification is one using the groupings, bars and lounges. There are lot of differences among the operations in each of these broad categories. There are bars that serve beverages only, with some offerings like light snacks, such as wafers, peanuts, finger chips, etc. However, some serve a limited food menu with beverages as their primary offering. Bar and beverage operations are defined by their goals and the type of clientele they serve. The concept of cocktail bar gives a heavy push to bar industry in terms of modernization. The main focus and specialty of this bar is to serve various kinds of cocktails. However, the bar is fully equipped with different forte of alcoholic beverages, which includes whiskey, vodka, rum, gin, tequila, various liqueurs, etc. This kind of specialty bars is mostly seen at luxury hotels, airport, cruises, casinos, etc. Number 2 is wine bar. In this era of modernization, a new concept introduced by hotels, which is becoming very popular amongst wine connoisseurs and affluent people. These bars sell various kinds of wines of different countries, regions, and various grape varieties. Usually, these bars serve most expensive wines. The menu is fully designed with various varieties of wines. However, different parameters like localization of product, food and wine combination, most selling brands, customer preferences, etc. need to be kept in mind while designing the wine list of the bar. Moreover, the customer can choose from a selection of wines by the glass or by the bottle, beginning with inexpensive house wines and going up in quality and price as far as the entrepreneur cares to go. A full menu or fruit and cheese platters and upscale olives can be served as well. Number third is sports bar. This specialty bar offers a various types of entertainment, specially caters to sports fan and contains several televisions and often sports memorabilia. Further, the definition stated that the bars or tavern featuring various LED screens for viewing sporting events is known as sports bar. The specialty of the bar is to serve fresh beers, draught beers of different varieties. The bar is having full forte of alcoholic beverages as well. This kind of bar often sets a fixed price or cover charge to guarantee a good profit because customer turnover is so small in these types of bars. The fourth one is pubs. The concept of pubs is originally from Britain, where they usually serve beers in the outlet. The main focus of pubs is to serve all kinds of beers along with other alcoholic beverages. These outlets run light music and there is no concept of dance floor in pubs. To market their products, most of the pubs were once owned by the breweries. Further, they are promoted by other business promoters. It is notified that originally they were owned by breweries to sell their beers in India. Cities like Bangalore and Mumbai have some of the finest pubs. The fifth one is nightclubs. These types of bar operates during the nights and offers dinners, dance, entertainment, which is the best suit bar in this category. Floor shows are the main attraction of the nightclub. Couples can dance floor to music performed by live bands or to recorded music. Dinner and wine are served at the tables and guests can have their meal while enjoying the show. In India, some metro cities have nightclubs. However, in some states, it is not permitted. Further, discotheque operates during night hours. It provides a dance floor for guests to dance on. Special sound and lighting effects is created for an appropriate ambience. Drinks, especially beer and snacks, are made available during the operations. The service is very informal in this type of bars. The sixth one is lounge bar. In this concept of bar, the guest feels more comfortable than the other bars and where the drinks are usually more expensive. The lounge bar usually located on the lobby level of hotel. However, it is an area which meant for relaxing. Most of the lounge bars serve all kinds of alcoholic beverages to the guests. In many establishments, lounges have their own bar as well. But the ones who do not have their bar, the drinks may be collected from the main bar and carried on a tray to the lounge and then being served. Seventh one is the portable bars. The portable bars are also termed as banquet bars, where they are designed for maximum flexibility and can be used in conjunction with beverage sales associated with guest activities anywhere in the hotel or on its grounds. This may be extended in resort areas to include recreational areas. Many outsource companies and bars started the venture of bar catering as well, where they provide the various bar setups, designs, beverage service in weddings, receptions, house parties, corporate events, etc. The hotels usually use this temporary type of bar setup in the banquet, where they serve various types of alcoholic and non-alcoholic beverages during the event. The next one, eighth one, is the service bar. This kind of bar, also termed as dispense bar, usually designed to help other outlets of F&B service department. The outlets who do not have their personal bars can collect their beverage orders from dispense bar. It may serve one or more food service areas and even room service, and it is designed specifically for efficiency and economy of service. This bar also serves alcoholic beverages to the guests who dine in the restaurant. In most cases, speed is considered the essential ingredient in service bars. Service bars typically are centrally located in the back of the house, which is out of the guest view. The other concept, the ninth one, is the mini bar. It is a new facility popular in many hotels, in which individual rooms often have a mini bar, which is a small refrigerator or cabinet stocked with a modest inventory of snacks and drinks, ostensibly for the convenience of hotel guests. Further, the 10th one is cigar bar, one more addition in the bar and beverage industry. The cigar bar offers extensive cigar selections as well as single malt scotches, small batch bourbons, cognacs and ports are filling an interesting upscale niche. This kind of bars target the niche market and helps in generating more revenue to the outlets. The customers visiting these bars to enjoy high priced cigars also have the opportunity to order premium spirits, wines, beers and after dinner drinks to accompany them. 11th one is the hookah bar. At the end of 2008, there were 470 hookah bars listed on the website called hookahbars.com in the United States, and an average of 5 open every month. Most hookah bar enthusiasts are in the under 30 crowd and have welcomed the trendy water pipe smoking as the new hip things to do. However, with most states banning cigarette smoking in degrees, small and large, in public places, cigars and hookah bars may not be long lasting establishments. This brings up a controversial issue in the bar and restaurant industry today: whether or not to allow smoking. In many cities and states, allowing bar customers to smoke indoors is no longer the prerogative of the business owners. Now I will discuss about the different parts of bar. The bar itself is dependent on functionality and looks. A straight line bar is avoided as far as possible, as patrons are looking at the back of the bar and usually at themselves, as most back bars are mirrored. The bar should be designed with respect to the volume of drinks that will be served from it, and not only from the point of view of the decor of the bar. A bar has various parts which are as follows. Number one, the front bar. The front bar is the customer area, contains the bar counter, which is alcohol proof that is 16 to 18 inch wide and armrest along the front edge, usually padded. The vertical structure of about 42 to 48 inch called the bar die. A footrest along the front about 12 inches of the ground. These elements are part of the public perception, hence due care must be taken in their design. The second one is the back bar. The back bar has a dual function, decorative display and hardworking storage, and is the soul of the bar. It conveys an image, stimulates conversation and displays wares and post information and logos. The base of the back bar is usually used as storage space for bottles, glass frosters, ice machines and mechanical dishwashers and even cash registers. The third one is the under bar. This is the part that is beneath the countertop and is the workhorse of the bar and holds all equipments and supplies for the products that is being sold. The pouring station has the individual supply of liquor, ice mixes, glasses, blender and garnishes. The most popular drinks are in a speed receptacle called the speed rail, an automatic dispensing unit called the Cobra gun. It also contains a sink for washing, bottle coolers, draught beer dispensing units and electrical lines. The standard width is 3 feet between the back bar and the under bar. So basically this is a work area of the bartender. The next one is the bar floor. The bar floor should be hard and non-porous, example tiles for the comfort of the feet, but spills and breakages are higher. Bartenders are on their feet for hours. Carpets and woods are not recommended. Rubbered and plastic mats used to minimize slippage but must be cleaned regularly. Further, I will talk about bar staffing. In bar, there are various bar staffing, which is starting from bar manager. If I talk about the hierarchy level, it starts from bar manager, then head bartender, bartenders, floor staff. I would like to discuss about the responsibilities of this staff. Firstly, I will talk about the bar manager. He is responsible for all functions of the bar and dispense bar. The responsibilities of a bar manager includes recruiting staff and training them for bar operations. His duty is to supervise alcohol service, forecasting volume of sales, maintaining a close watch on movement of bottles, preparing budgets for bar, formulating beverage control system, maintain quality of services, handling guest complaints. The next one is head bartender. He she is responsible for the overall functions of the bar. Their duties are supervising bartenders, scheduling rota and day off for bar staff, receiving stock from the seller against the requisition, maintaining par stock level in the bar, training bar staff in making cocktails, preparing glasses for drinks, garnishing drinks, service procedures, recording orders, etc. He is responsible for taking and closing and opening stock, maintaining empty bottle record, even assisting the bar manager in his daily duties and relieving him during his day off and holidays. Next is the bartender. Bartender is responsible for mixing and serving drinks to guests, seated at the counter. He is responsible for pouring required measures against beverage order ticket for bar waiters to serve guests at the table. Washing glassware and bar tools, recording sales, receiving cash from guests or getting bills signed by residential guests, taking note of their room number is his duties. Establishing good relationship with customers as well. He is responsible for taking opening and closing stock as well. Next one is bar waiter. He, she is responsible for many things like keeping the mise en place ready for beverage service at the table, recording beverage order on beverage order ticket and collecting them from the bar, serving guests alcoholic drinks at the table in bar, restaurants or lounges, clearing glasses and leaving them for wash, collecting payments from the chance guests or getting the bill signed by residential guests comes under his or her duties. Now I will discuss about the bar equipments. Bar equipments consist of many different types of machines, storage units, dispensing units and tools. All equipments can be categorized with respect to their use and must be selected based on their durability, function, appearance and ease of care. Firstly, number one, I would like to discuss about the dispensing equipment. These consist of automatic systems that dispense aerated beverages through a Cobra gun. They are very convenient and some guns dispense up to 10 different types of beverages from water and soda to colas and tonic water. Second one is beer panel. This is the dispensing point from which beer is served or pulled. It consists of three main components, that is number one is tap, cooler and a drip tray. Third one is mixers and blenders. These units have their uses in the bar in mixing drinks. Mixers are used to blend drinks that incorporated ice in them like slushes and frozen drinks. They are also used for large volume drinks. Blenders on the other hand are used as alternative for the cocktail shaker for fasting dispensing the drinks. Number fourth is the washing equipment. This could be a simple three sink arrangement with drain boards used in conjunction with glassware brushes, pressure hose, hand wash unit and towel rack and waste bin. Alternatively, it could be an automatic glass washing unit with full cycle of washing, rinsing and drying of different capacities for customized applications. Number 5 is ice machines. This is a unit which the bar cannot do without as ice is required in plentiful. Selection of ice machines will depend among other factors: shape of the cube for quick chilling without diluting, clarity and density, size for easy blending and output. Apart from ice cube machine, a bar may have ice flaker and ice crusher units as well. Number 6 is the storage equipment. A bar requires a lot of storage space for the storage of various items like liquor, mixes, wine and beer, bottles, garnishes and other service equipment. So provision should be made for liquor cabinets, wine coolers, beer chillers and refrigerators to store juices, pre-mixes, garnishes, glass frosters and shelving to store display bottles and glassware. Further, I will discuss about the tools and small equipments used in bar operation. The small tools are usually made of steel for their durability and ease of maintenance. Number one is jiggers, or we can say as peg measurers. It comes in various shapes and sizes like 30 ml, 45 ml, 60 ml, 90 ml capacities. Number two is pourers. Pourers are devices attached to the neck of a bottle for quick dispensing, called a free pour. Other one is a measure control pourers. Number three is cocktail shakers. It comes in two forms, the three-part all-metal Manhattan shaker and the two-part Boston shaker with one glass and one metal part. The glass part is also used as for mixing drinks. The ice is strained from a Boston shaker using a Hawthorne strainer, a spring-loaded strainer with a handle. Number fourth is bar spoon. A long bar spoon is used to stir build-up cocktails and for tasting. Number fifth is ice scoop. Ice scoops come in metal or plastic version, the latter reducing noise and chipping of glasses. Number six is muddler, which is used to prepare the muddle cocktails. A muddler used to mash mint leaves or lemon can be made from a type of hardwood or nowadays in hard plastic. Number seventh is fruit squeezers and glass reamers. They are the other equipments used in bar. Number eight is condiment tray, which is a handy for storage of garnishes, swizzle sticks, straws, etc. Number nine is cutting board. It is used on the work table for cutting the garnishes or preparing the cocktails. Number 10 is the bar knife or waiter's friend. It completes the essential along with the beverage round or salver. Now I will discuss about the bar glassware, which is one of the main component in bars. Glassware used in a bar is crucial in the overall look of the bar. It is not only essential in the dispensing of beverages, but plays a pivotal role in the overall status of the bar. Glass shape can range from tall, sleek, frosted to oversized glasses, colorful goblets, crystal tumblers and attractive steins. Whatever the shape, a glass has three parts: the bowl, the base and foot and the stem, and named after these characteristics, that is tumbler, footed ware and stemware. There are different types of glasses, like number one, beer glasses. Different styles of glassware complement different styles of beers for a variety of reasons, including enhancing aromatic volatiles, showcasing the appearance and having an effect on the beer head. The standard size of beer glass is 12 ounces. Second one is wine glasses. Wine glasses for still table wines should be made of clear glass so that the color of the wine can be inspected. The glasses should have stems so that the drinker does not have to hold the bowl of the glass. Next one is sherry glass, which is usually a small glass with a stem holding about 90 ml. Is used not only for sherry but also for all fortified wines such as port, marsala and madeira. Next one is champagne glass. Champagne is served in tall, narrow flutes or tulip glasses, which concentrates the mousse and the bouquet. The traditional champagne saucer is nowadays used primarily as a cocktail glass. Next, I talk about cocktail glass. This type of glassware usually used to serve cocktails of less quantity like martinis, daiquiri, etc. It is also called as martini glass. The standard size of this glass is 5 ounces. However, these days in industry, this glass comes under various sizes like between 5 ounces to 8 ounces. The next one is margarita glass. The classic margarita glass has a wide rim and long stem. Salt is usually applied to the rim. Margarita glasses come in an enormous variety of colors, sizes and shapes. The other one is old-fashioned glass. This kind of glassware usually used to serve whiskey or the drinks which serves on the bed of ice. This is the reason this glassware also known as rock glass, which means the drink is served on full ice. The size of the glassware is between 7 to 10 ounces. The next one is a shot glass, a very small barrel shaped glass, typically around 2 to 3 ounces in volume. This glass is used to serve any liquor. The other one is brandy snifter. A snifter, also called as a balloon, is a type of stemware glass whose vessel has a wide bottom and a relatively narrow top. It is mostly used to serve brandy. Most snifters will hold between 6 to 8 ounces. The next one is a highball glass. A highball glass is a glass tumbler which contains 8 to 12 fluid ounces. It is used to serve highball cocktails and other mixed drinks. The next one is a colin glass. A colin glass is a glass tumbler which typically will contain 10 to 14 fluid ounces. It is used to serve long cocktails, mixed drinks, especially Tom Colin cocktails. It is cylindrical in shape and narrower than a highball glass. Now, I would like to summarize the whole module that beverage service is a major component and has remained an important part of hospitality industry today. The beverage services are provided by various outlets of food and beverage department in the hotel. These outlets are bars, room service, banquet, restaurant, 24 hours coffee shop, lounges, etc., which serves alcoholic as well as non-alcoholic beverages. Alcoholic beverages demand, particularly wine, is changing and growing nowadays. To fulfill its demand, there are various types of bars in the market which sells the alcoholic beverages to the public to consume the drinks on the premises. It means that bars are involved in the sale of alcoholic beverages. However, their main concern is to sell and consume the beverages on the premises. And that was all from my side. Thank you and have a nice time ahead.